You hit it off with a bumper, now you're straight down the middle again. You hit a fling with a slingshot, you're rolling out the alley again. I try to cradle you with my flipper, it was all in vain. Baby, 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 why are you doing me wrong?
Doing wrong.
Don't you remember the good days when we used to get along? We'd make the score real spin all night, then we'd be singing our song. You said life was getting bland, so you brought two friends in.
What's happening, everybody? It's Zach. I'm here with Tom in Indiana, a local pinball collector. He's nice enough to invite us into his home so that we can see his collection, interview him, and talk about all things pinball, as well as some other hobbies that you have that we'll talk about here. So Tom, what got you into pinball, man?
Back in the 80s, my dad, he had a route.
Nice.
I don't know how many machines he had. I was just a little kid.
Was he like a pinball router or like an arcade? Or
mostly arcades, but there was a few pinballs always floating around my whole life. We had a cabin down in southern Indiana, and there was always a pinball machine in there.
Nice.
Played it a lot.
Do you remember any of the titles?
Yeah, nah, it was Knight Rider.
I don't even know that one. I wonder who made that. It was a Gottlieb game or something, maybe? I don't know. I don't know what Knight Rider
is. I think it's a Bally.
Nice.
It's a Bally. They made it. It was actually
70s or 80s?
It was 70s, 80s. Cool. Right there, they made them both ways. They were EM and
solid state. Oh, so it was right at that turn.
Yep, they made them both ways.
Nice. Have you seen one since?
No, if anybody has one.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Contact Zach.
Yeah, bring back some memories.
Absolutely.
Very nice. So he was routing, got into the business. So you remember playing pinballs as a kid?
Yeah, probably more the video game in.
Yeah, very nice.
Tapper. I remember Tapper.
You don't have any arcade games, do you?
No.
Oh, very nice.
I don't do arcades.
So you like that? I'm with you, man. I'm not a big arcade. Each their own, the arcade people, but I'll play PlayStation 4 if I want to play a video game.
Strictly pinball.
Yeah, strictly pinball. We should get t-shirts.
Strictly
pinball. All right, so Knight Rider, he gets into the business. You were a kid of the 80s too, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah, hell yeah. So we got into pinball machines, and when did you start picking it up after that? So what happened? What was the next thing?
We went to a pizza restaurant.
Gotcha.
And a guy had brought two pinball machines in that were in the store. It was an NBA Fast Break. That would have been 2005.
Okay.
And started playing that and just fell in love with pinball again.
Very nice. So NBA Fast Break, you heard it here, is what kind of got you back into...
Yeah, it was the NBA Fast Break.
And you know what? We'll see here in a little bit, there's an NBA Fast Break in the arcade down there.
Absolutely.
Very nice. All right. So how long you been in the hobby, man?
2006, I bought a NBA Fast Break.
Cool.
And a year after that, I bought a Monster Bash
and then as we'll see here soon, they're like bunnies. They continue to multiply over and over.
They got out of control pretty quick.
Expensive bunnies is what they were.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it was Fast Break, no BS, but Fast Break was your first?
That was my first machine that I purchased.
That's super cool. So he brought in a Fast Break.
I didn't purchase the Fast Break that the guy had on route at our restaurant. I actually found one. I think I bought it on eBay.
Oh, yeah. So you overpaid on eBay?
Overpaid, absolutely.
We all do that,
overpaid.
Our first couple mistakes.
It was the
mistakes.
First one.
Yeah.
I still overpay for them sometimes if I really want it.
If you really want it.
If I really want it, I'll still overpay.
So NBA Fast, I think it's really cool how you got your first machine was NBA Fast Break. So what is your favorite machine?
Favorite machine at this time would have to be Lord of the Rings.
Nice.
Lord of the Rings. The Hobbit would be a second.
It's a similar theme.
Similar theme. Two totally different machines for me.
Yeah.
The Hobbit for me seems like a machine that they're long ball times, mm-hmm. long gameplay.
Multi-ball everywhere. Yeah.
Absolutely.
I love it.
I don't know how to describe The Hobbit. You play for so long.
After you're done, you feel spent. I do.
Yeah.
After I play The Hobbit, if I just kick its ass, I feel satisfied, but then I'm like, okay, it's time to go play Bram Stoker Dracula for a little
bit. You're wore out.
That's right.
You're wore out for sure.
So do you like longer ball times on games, or you just like it to be varied?
Varied.
Okay.
But that machine is kind of a special machine to me. I don't play it all the time.
Mm-hmm.
I play it when I have a half hour,
that's right.
45 minutes, an hour to kill.
It's a fun half an hour to
it
kill.
It is fun half
Now, you told me the coolest thing when it came to Lord of the Rings. You said that you... you bought the game and never even seen the damn movies.
I had never seen the movies.
Yeah.
Played The Hobbit.
Mm-hmm.
And I played The Hobbit, then watched all the movies, and then decided, okay, I need to buy Lord of the Rings
too. Oh, very cool.
And they're two totally different machines.
And then you kind of just fell in love with them. What do you think about the movies?
Love them.
Yeah, I love them too.
Love them.
They're really cool. So Lord of the Rings, Hobbit are kind of the apex right now.
Absolutely.
Two machines. Cool. All right. What machine do you love, Tom, but everybody freaking hates?
I would have to say, I don't know if everybody hates NBA Fast Break, but I know it's not.
A lot of people, yeah. You can get them for $2,500 anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you like that one. Most people don't like that. What about the other side of things? Which game do you hate that a lot of people just love and rave over, and you're like, I just don't get it?
Star Trek The Next Generation.
Wow. Oof. Slow down, guys. Yeah, that's a really popular pinball machine. What do you hate about it?
I don't know what it is.
No?
I can't describe it.
It's kind of a brutal game.
It's
not very deep. It's got a... Final Frontier's pretty easy to get to. Not pretty easy. I'm not great at pinball, but it's pretty attainable. There's not a big payoff. The Borg shot's cool. How you do the third flipper... And it locks the ball up in that little ship and then shoots it back out at you?
I haven't played it long enough. It's not captured me long enough.
It's not captured you long enough?
No.
I love it.
Not captured
so me long enough. So is it the theme too? Do you just, you're not a Trek guy? Or?
I'm not a Trekker, no.
Yeah. Okay.
Nothing against, you know.
No, I think a lot of people, I think that is a love-hate kind of game though. A lot of people either love it or they hate it. Yeah. But a lot of you guys do love that game. I'm with you though, brother. I hate to tell you guys, but I had one for a little bit. It was beautiful, but... It did nothing for me.
There is one other, and I have it, but that's Tales of the Arabian Nights.
What?
I.
Wow.
I don't.
This
hate
is where
it.
We pause the game and we talk about me purchasing that game.
I don't hate
wow.
it.
Wow.
I'm still giving it a chance, you know.
Wow. I hope you continue to hate it, man.
I've had it for about 3 or 4.
We're gonna
years.
Edit this part out so nobody knows that you hate it. Yeah. Now, you know what? To be fair, that is a game where it has a lot of flow. It's got a lot of sneaky shots. I love the ramp shots. But I do tend to get bored after a while because there are long ball times. I mean,
not for me.
Really?
That lamp eats me alive.
Really? Maybe it's the... Well, that does kick back at you. That's interesting. I love that that's something different. I like that. All right. What else do I got? How many machines do you own? Have we counted lately?
What did we count? 24?
This is pretty sad. He doesn't know because he has so many games.
24.
Yeah. 24?
24.
What about the one, do you have one on location?
One on location. So WWE will be on location.
Okay.
And then Big Lebowski is on the way.
Oh yeah, he does have a Big Lebowski. It's and you're going to be so kind.
Absolutely.
Enough
come
for
on
us
back.
To come review it. Greg and I will come. We'll review the Big Lebowski. Let's hope it works out of the box. How about that?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
if not, that'll suck. When are you getting that thing?
I think June, they said.
Okay. Who are you getting a Bowski from?
Coin Takers.
Nice. So, Melissa at Coin Taker then.
Yep.
I think, you know what, they might have the rights to... I don't know if there's any other distributors that are actually getting it. I don't know.
I don't think there is.
Yeah. Okay, cool. All right. What machine... Oh, this is my favorite question because I already know the answer to this thing. What machine do you regret getting rid of?
I've never got rid of a machine.
You've never got rid of a machine, so you don't have to worry about that. Okay, what's your favorite pinball show, expo, place to kind of go as a conference kind of thing for pinball?
Michigan, it's pretty friendly.
Where is it? Oh, I'm trying to think where it's at in Michigan.
I can't remember.
Where is it? I don't know. Sorry, guys. It's... And is it by Detroit?
If they're still having it. I know that it used to be in, when was it, the fall?
She's not going to help you off camera here, is she?
No, she's not. What was that show?
She's staying silent.
She can't remember either.
It's all good. All right, so Michigan show you really like. Is there anything specific you really like about it, or is it just set up really nice?
Set up really nice. Cool. It's at a college.
At a college? I didn't know that. That's awesome.
And it's...
Are there college kids on campus at the time?
Yeah.
Oh, that's neat.
Just roaming around.
Yeah, so a lot of liquor, a lot of college students.
No, pinball. I don't think it, you know, I don't think there's any of that going on.
Oh, of course, no alcohol at a pinball show, right?
There is no alcohol there. There's no alcohol being sold or anything.
Not sold. But you know who you guys are. I guarantee you guys got the little flask and the, yeah. You don't think so? Well, they're plastered there.
I don't know.
What machine would you love to own?
Circus Voltaire.
I'd like to own one of those too.
I let a Circus Voltaire and an Attack from Mars get away.
Okay.
Years ago.
I don't think you should be that hurt about the Attack from Mars. I'm kind of an Attack from Mars hater. I like the game, but I'm not going to spend that much money on it.
You got to have it, though. You got to have it.
I wish I could say I have
the collection. If you're going to build a collection, it's got to be.
My collection of three. Yeah. I've got to have it.
But if you're going to put it together, the ultimate collection, it's got to be.
That's a great point. It's true. I'm just jealous because you have 25 machines, I have three.
And that's why Tales of the Arabian Nights is.
Yeah, you got to keep it kind of in there.
It's in there.
Very nice. Very nice. Okay, so Circus Voltaire. You want a Circus Voltaire?
I want a Circus Voltaire.
It's a really pretty game. I like that game. All right. I was going to ask, how long do most games stay in your collection?
And that's forever.
That's a joke. What games have been in your collection? We'll see that in a minute. So let's say you're going to buy a game. Tom, what turns you off when you're buying a game?
Popped inserts.
Okay.
And ghosted inserts.
Popped and ghosted inserts.
Yeah.
Well, good luck finding a Circus Voltaire without ghosted inserts, my friend.
I let one of those get away.
Yeah, oh man. So ghosted inserts, insert damage in general, just, you know you're going to have to mess with the playfield.
Yeah, it's hard to repair.
Yeah. And you're pretty handy, from what I know about you. You're not afraid to get in there.
No. But inserts, it's hit or miss, whether it's going
to Well, you know you're going to have to strip the thing, and you're going to have to get a clear coat.
If you're going to pop one out, it pops a lot more than just the insert.
Yeah, you got clear coat and stuff to worry about. That's true. Good point. Let's see. Do you have any other weird hobbies? Because pinball is kind of a weird
obsession. Too many
hobbies. Okay. What do you like to do?
I play bass.
Play bass?
Play bass.
Okay.
Blacksmith. Are you any good? No, terrible.
Okay.
Let's say I own a bass.
So you own a bass.
How about that?
Fine.
Yeah. I own one.
So blacksmith.
Blacksmithing.
The hell's a blacksmith nowadays? Do you have a stand down at the corner and just hammering away on an anvil?
No.
Is that a blacksmith joke?
That's a thing.
Is that what blacksmiths do?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll take it. What have you smithed?
Mostly fire pokers. They're quick and easy, and
you can
knock them out in 30-40 minutes.
I'm gonna have to later on check out some of the stuff that you've. Is it smithed? What is the term? You smith it?
Smithing.
Smithing.
Smith.
Smithing. I think of Simpsons. Smithing. What else do you like? You like darts?
Darts.
Yeah, you're a big
darts
player.
Darts are fine.
Yeah.
I'm not very good at it, but I like it.
Same with pinball and me. Love pinball. I'm just not very
Same
good
here.
At it.
Same here. I just
you're
have
pretty them. Good at pinball.
I don't know.
Yeah,
there's no one. That's the thing. There's no one in this area that plays pinball.
Yeah, I'm kind of in a
So I don't know if I'm good at pinball or bad at pinball. I may be.
You're the grand champion on all your machines.
Yeah.
That's very. What I love about Tom is that he's kind of a no bullshit kind of guy. You come into his place, he's got some of the greatest machines, but super humble. And it's like, I don't care. They're pinballs, and I love them, and I love playing. I don't really care about certain little things that a lot of people stress over. That's really
cool. Yeah, if you like it, you like it. I'm not snobby about it. I don't think anybody should be snobby about the hobby. That's pinball. You like what you like, you don't like what you don't like.
It is very true. All right, so we are going to go to Tom's collection. This is a smaller portion of his collection. We'll talk about these, and then we're going to go down to his arcade and show off some more machines. So let's go to the machines. All right, so let's go over the collection. We're going to start with one of the most beautiful games I think ever made, X-Men Magneto Limited Edition. So this is one of your newer games, right?
Yes.
Okay. So you probably haven't got a lot of time on it, but tell me, of the things that you have played the games so far, What do you like on this thing?
The multi-ball is awesome.
The multi-ball is really cool on this, yeah. So
the
it's...
balls get this center insert spins.
Yep. It's got the magnet.
It's got a magnet, and it holds them. And
so this is actually, what's cool about the Magneto is it has a four-ball multi-ball. So you actually, I think, don't you have to lock four balls?
You have to lock four.
Or you lock three and then hit it and then it catches or something like that. But it's a four-ball multi-ball, I think.
Right.
Yeah. So the multi-ball is really cool. It's got a spinning disc with a magnet in it. They'll all fall down, they'll lock onto there, and then they'll start spinning and balls will balls go
everywhere. Scatter everywhere, yeah.
Yeah. This is a really loaded down game for any of you guys who have not played an X-Men. You got to get the limited edition, though. But if you haven't played an X-Men, it's loaded down. It's a board game, so really cool, unique layout. Tight shots, a lot going on. Third flipper, it's a really cool game. You have to check it out. Very underrated game. Very cool. All right. Let's move down to your favorite.
Lord of the Rings, yes.
Lord of the Rings. So what do you hate about this game? Let's start with that. Is there anything at all that you hate about this game?
That Balrog.
All right. Especially when you start in a mode.
But no, I don't hate it. Yeah, it's one of those love-hate things.
What do you love about the game? Why do you love? I mean, if this is your favorite game, what is it that really just drives you on this thing?
In the past, when I found a favorite machine, after probably, I don't know, 50 plays on a machine, I've got it figured out.
Mm-hmm.
And you pretty much do what you want to the machine. You can hit any shot you want.
That's right, very true.
This machine, I have trouble with it. Uh-huh. And I like that.
Oh, that's cool.
And I'm probably never going to see Valinor on this machine.
I won't either, brother.
I'm going to keep trying.
There's something about having a game that you know you're never going to beat. Or it's just going to kick your butt over and over again. And it's going to be really hard to...
You'll never get tired of it.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. It's got good flow for it. It's got a lot of things. What I like about this is, it's not just get through the modes, here's your wizard. It is, well, you got to get through the modes, then you got to get the gifts of the elves, well, and then you got to get through all the multi-balls, and then don't forget all the rings down here, and then don't forget, you know.
And if you blow it anywhere along the line, you got to go back and do it again.
That's right. And then the only way to get gifts from the elves, you have to complete the modes, not just start them.
Yeah.
So she's a mean one, but it is super fun. I'm with you. This is just
awesome. It keeps
you
coming back.
It sure does. And it's beautiful. It's really nice. All right, let's work our way down to probably one of your newest pins, right?
Yeah, Ghostbusters. This is one.
This is the premium.
I absolutely hated this machine.
I did too the first time I played it.
When I first got it, yeah. I thought, why did I buy this thing?
Uh-huh.
And I cussed it, and I cussed it.
You still probably cuss it.
Not so much anymore.
Yeah?
I've grown to love it a lot.
What do you love about it?
For one, it will eat you alive.
It doesn't care either.
It's a pretty fast game.
It'll tear you up.
I did kind of cheat and put the carrot flippers on it.
That's personalization.
Personalization. I closed that gap up a little bit, and then I put the center post in.
That's the thing. There's no hate here because you're making the game how you enjoy it.
Yeah, I think now it's almost like training wheels. I think
that's
I can take those off
of there
now.
That's a good analogy.
But in the beginning, that flipper gap was... It drove me nuts.
It's a monster.
Because when you play every other pinball machine you've ever played,
yeah,
except for what, Creature?
Yeah, John Trudeau games, but yeah.
You just, you have that.
That's a feel. That's right.
You
that's
feel
exactly
it,
right. Mm-hmm.
And you know where the ball's coming out.
You know
out.
Where it's going to land out the slings, like if it bumps the sling, you know you've got a little room to wiggle.
And you didn't have that.
No, you don't have that at all. Especially the outlanes, those metal outlanes. They tingle one of them things. It ain't a rubber, it's going to bounce out.
Those never bobbing. It was always the flippers.
Very nice. What do you not like about this game? Any shots in particular that you don't like?
This
I'm leading him on because I know which one
yeah,
he's going to say.
Yeah, everybody hates this shot. It's not achievable. And it may be that the carrot flippers.
You're going to blame it on the carrot flippers and not the design of the game?
It
good for you.
It could be the design. This ramp could have been.
Guess what, buddy? Everybody else that hates that shot, a lot of them don't have carrot flippers. I don't think it's.
It won't go up that ramp at all, period.
It goes up and then comes back down.
It's physically impossible.
I think if you guys have the same problem, there is a thread on Pinside. I think it's Ghostbusters Fixes or something like that. Some people have actually tried to modify it in some way to get it to work better, but some machines I think are just going to be better than others on it.
You know, I don't want to knock the game.
I do like this game. It's one of my favorites. I love it.
It would have been nice to see that moved over a little bit. The shot's not hard to hit.
Okay.
I don't find that the shot's hard to hit. I can hit the shot over and over.
On the Pro, the shot is hard to hit. But you don't have to worry about rejects, really. I mean, it'll coast right up there.
With this, I don't have trouble hitting the shot.
Such a pretty game to get the side blades on it and everything. Get the topper. I'm too tight to buy that topper, and I blow money. I do, too. I love it, too.
I don't do a lot of mods or...
Different things, yeah.
Yeah, I don't do any of that, but...
Well, you had to get your deflector there, so that's good.
I did get the deflector. If you have a Ghostbusters, you gotta get the deflector.
You've got to get that. Cool. Very nice. That's a cool game. All right. A lot of people's favorite here. Whitewater.
This is not my machine. Oh. This is my wife's only machine.
There you go. So the wife's machine.
Yeah, I was not allowed to bring any more machines home until...
Until you brought a Whitewater home?
And it's fun.
I think it's a good call by her because it is a fun, flowy game. If you like ramps, man, this is it.
Absolutely.
It's got the best ramps in the business. What do you love about this game? That your wife loves it?
Yeah, I love that she loves it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know which game my wife just loves? Not a damn one. She hates them all. Oh, she liked The Hobbit a little bit because it was pretty and had to scream and stuff, but... She doesn't like very many of them. So, what do you hate about this game? Anything you hate? I'm trying to think what I don't like about this game. I love that ramp.
I drain a lot on this outline here.
Yeah.
The right outline gets
That's
me.
A satisfying little shot through those pop bumpers, though.
That's a tough shot.
Yeah, it is. It's a very tough shot. This game is solid. This game is a classic for a reason.
It's got a lot going for it. It's got a lot of cool
music,
shots.
Music, call-outs.
It's whimsical.
It's very whimsical. The artwork is awesome. Y'all see the artwork? It's a really cool game. I like it.
I bought this game from Zach, and he did an excellent job on the LEDs.
Look at that. Thank you, buddy. Yeah. I LED'd that. I had fun LED'ing.
He did a good job. It's excellent up here.
See?
Yeah.
I do love
even the different different... Tones of blue, you know.
Stop.
I like it.
Let's go talk about another game. Tom, we've got here a clinkety clankety. What is it? What does it say on the thing? We've got a Wizard of Oz. What do you think about your Wizard of Oz?
I love it.
You like this thing?
I love it.
What do you think about Jersey Jack games?
I love it.
Yeah.
I love Jersey Jack.
You love The Hobbit. Yep. Love Wizard of Oz. What about Dialed In?
Got to play Dialed In.
Yeah. What'd you think?
I was nervous about the theme at first. I'll admit it. But after playing it. That's an awesome machine.
It's a freaking awesome machine.
It's super awesome.
And now everybody's pumped up to see what the number 4 title is going to be. And I'm always like, Zach, slow your roll, man. Let Dialed In come out. See what they're going to come out with. So what do you love about The Wizard of Oz?
It's pretty. I don't use the word pretty.
I do, unfortunately, too much. But this is a very pretty machine. Yeah, any specific... And we were talking about this a little bit before, and you're telling me a little bit about what you don't like about the machine.
I don't like that it slows down a lot.
I gotta not touch your invisi glass. I'm sorry. I don't have my rubber gloves on.
But it's not that I don't like it. It's just it's different.
It's a stop and flow kind of, or stop and go kind of.
It is, and that's okay.
I'm good with that. Simpsons is like that. It's a great game. You know what I hate about this game? For as colorful as it is, it's so damn dark. Like when I'm playing this game, sometimes. I want to get some extra spots in there or something, which is an easy fix, but that's the only thing. Everything else, it's one of the best games ever made, I think. It's awesome. What about the theme? Everybody always complains about the theme of Wizard of Oz.
I like the theme.
I grew up on it, so.
It's a great theme. It fits for everyone. Everybody knows the Wizard of Oz.
So he's got, if you guys see, for those of you who don't know, a lot of you guys know, but the red candy powder coated is the 75th anniversary Ruby Red Edition. It's got the Playfield habit trails that are powder coated as well.
And I don't have the topper on. I gotta take it down. It's going to the basement.
Yeah.
So I don't have it on.
It's going to the arcade. So I love the game. I think it's really cool. I like the 75th anniversary. You kind of have to spring for that so you can get the Invisiglass, get the Tornado, get the Walls, get Toto. You get a lot of extra stuff.
I'm super happy.
Yeah. I think it's beautiful. Very nice. Let's go look at the next one.
I didn't see you there.
All right,
were
Tom.
You doing it? I want to.
We're keeping it. We're keeping that. That's right. Good. The Hobbit Black Arrow Edition. What made you want to get the Black Arrow Edition? It's the newest version.
It's the newest version. I wanted an Ellie.
Okay. So you weren't picky. You're like, I like black. Sure. Looks pretty sharp. For those of you out there, we're talking Tom into getting Larry at Flipping Out Pinball, the mod that goes on here, the little gold ring and the metal plate and the gold flipper rings. Really cool. Check him out on Flipping Out Pinball.
I will do that.
Yeah. What do you, this is one of your favorite games. What do you love about this? Because there's a lot of hate towards the Hobbit.
It is mode heavy.
It is about 31 of them.
And
31 modes. 3 wizard modes. Mini wizard, wizard.
Has anybody ever completed that?
I've got 2 barrel escape. That's about as far. I don't know if Battle of 5 Armies is coded, so I'm not sure.
I've done all the End of the Fire, Barrel Escape, and Battle of 5 Armies, but doing all the modes and completing all of them.
Oh yeah, you got into battle?
Yeah.
Nice. No.
I played for an hour.
I don't know if I've ever actually completed any of the actual wizard modes.
And I was tired.
I bet you were tired.
I beat.
We got extra balls on 10, Tom.
I beat. It's his factory. And I did defeat Smog or Smaug, however you want to say it.
That's satisfying, isn't it?
That's pretty cool.
That's cool.
That is super cool.
During that part, I never know what the hell to hit, though, because it's just a frenzy.
You just hit balls.
I love this game, man. I love this game. So, bare open play field.
That's the thing I like about a lot of machines. I like long shots.
Okay.
I've found that with machines. I do like long shots, so that's probably part of the love for
Greg me. And I will review this machine. We will happily review this machine. My favorite shot on this whole game are these orbits. I promise you, there's not a better orbit shot in pinball, in my opinion. It's a wide body, and it's smooth as butter. The spinner sounds are excellent. It feels so smooth and good. And then with the updated code, it'll catch that magnet. It'll catch it in the back to add a ball to your next mode. So that's my favorite shot. What do you love shooting at in this game? Because it's a shooter's game. Sounds like
I love them all. There's nothing about this game that I don't like.
It is very well done.
There's nothing about it I don't like. And I know that there is a lot of people out there that hate this machine.
You don't hear something crazy? Is that I like this more than I like Wizard of Oz.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
But
that's good. Most people would say we're out of our minds. But
no, I love this.
For me, I hate to spoiler our reviews coming up, but for me, all Jersey Jack games are great, but this is maybe the pinnacle. I love The Hobbit.
This machine is definitely underrated, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm. That's great. What we got next? We got a machine that everybody on Pinside would love to have. This is the AC/DC Lucy Edition. It's awesome. I had the Pro, wasn't crazy about the Pro, but the Lucy Edition is freaking where it's at, man. I mean, look at the art on this thing. The art is just awesome. What do you love about this game, my man?
Yeah, one of the guys I bought it from.
Yeah.
His wife did not appreciate it in his living room.
Oh, in the living room. I love it.
It was in his living room.
It's nice. It's like, Grandma, don't worry about the half-naked lady on my pinball machine in the middle of my living room. That's awesome.
But it's down here in the Thunder Dungeon.
Now. Oh, yeah. We forgot to tell you guys. Yeah, I forgot to introduce. He has named his arcade, and you guys will have to shoot us messages of the names of your arcades, but he has the best name of an arcade. It is the Thunder Dungeon.
It's a work in process.
Yeah. So you're still kind of fixing up the place down here. But
yeah, we're still, bare walls and everything.
It's the freaking Thunder Dungeon. Come on.
Or maybe we just leave it half finished.
Who cares? It's the Thunder Dungeon. Nobody cares. Yeah. It's awesome. It's just an unfinished place with thousands upon thousands
it's
of dollars.
It's like the arcades that you went to that's when true. You were a kid in the 80s.
Yeah, that's true. The Thunder Dungeon.
God knows what's on the floor.
God, I love it. So the Thunder Dungeon is holding AC/DC. Is this one of your favorite pins, or just this an AH pin to you, or what?
I think it's a little better than AH.
Okay.
Well, yeah.
But it's not.
It's better than AH to me.
It's better than AH.
What do you hate about it?
It's harder than hell.
It
eats me
really
alive.
It's hard. It's super hard. It's fast flowing game. Steve Ritchie, that's what he does best.
It's super fast.
I love the music.
Oh, yeah.
Like, for all the AC/DC hater fans, I love the music.
You know, I wasn't a big AC/DC
really?
Fan.
I love corny, so that's why I like Aerosmith. Everybody hates on Aerosmith.
Me like AC/DC way more than I ever would have.
Then it did its job, I guess.
Yeah, it did its job.
This is I love this game. It's cool. Very nice. What are we moving on to, my man? This turd bucket here.
Medieval
Madness.
Oh
my god.
This is the remake.
Who loves this game?
Nobody likes this game, do they?
Junker. This game's awesome. I wish I had one. I want this
one.
What
do you say about this?
I'll load it up.
It is what it is. What do you say about it?
You say it's number one on Pinside for a reason.
Yeah.
That's what you say. Ain't on a lot of people's top of list. It's majestic. It's fun. The call-outs are great. There's nothing to not... Like you said about The Hobbit, there's nothing really not to like about this game. Anything in particular that stands out to you about this game?
I like the call-outs. They're great.
They are cool. Just funky.
I like Lord Howard Hertz.
Lord
Hertz, what the fuck are you?
I love it. That's true. I like the castle. I like the ramps. I love that little shot back into the...
into the damsel?
Yes, the damsel shot. That's a satisfying shot. Very cool. You guys have played this. You guys love this. Now, this is the remake, right?
This is the remake.
Do you find that the remake is different than the regular?
I really don't.
About the same thing?
Other than 1998, I wasn't playing pinball, so I didn't know what a new...
Okay, yeah.
Out of the box... Williams machine felt like. I know it's not a Williams.
What made you want the remake over the old one, though?
I wanted something new.
You wanted new.
I wanted new.
So new components.
New everything. Yeah.
Yeah.
I wanted to play it. I like
new
to
posts,
work on machines.
New everything.
Yeah. I like to work on machines.
Okay.
So you know that about.
Yeah.
But this was one I just didn't want to. I wanted to play it.
You wanted to be nice.
I wanted to be nice. I wanted to play it. I'm that way with some machines. Some machines I don't care.
You're okay to work on different things. Yeah. Very nice.
If we get to my Earth Shaker over here, like I've told him, it's...
The Earth Shaker.
It looks terrible. But it plays. It's like the old
You said it plays
rock.
Damn good.
Yeah, it plays damn good.
Yeah, that's all that matters.
It's like
sometimes it's fun to have a machine that just looks like crap, but then you press the start button and you're like, oh crap, this is awesome.
It's playing.
Heck yeah. It's good. Like side decals are off and stuff. Who cares? All right. This is your baby, not many people's baby,
here
but
it
your
is.
Baby.
Yeah.
And I got a polar in my vase, all right?
And
what do you love about it? I've not had much time on it, so you've got to... I don't know anything about the fast break.
Well, the object, is to get four championship rings. You complete every shot on the game four times.
Okay.
You have to play against the machine once you get...
Oh, neat.
Through all the tasks of the machine.
Is that Scottie Pippen?
I think it is
Patrick Ewing.
Clyde the Glide.
I don't know why I don't like this, because back in the 80s and the 90s, collecting
basketball cards.
This is, I mean, I know all of these people, Anthony Hardaway and Grant Hill.
Yeah.
This is where it was at. So I'm going to have to take a look at this game a little bit more. You know what I need to do one day? I'm going to come here with a box full of LEDs, and I'm going
to
LED the hell out of this thing.
Sounds good.
Would you allow me to do that?
I will allow you to do that.
Heck yeah. I want to brighten this thing up. It's screaming LED me. What, any particular shots that you really like on this? Or anything, call-outs, music? I take it...
Call-outs, the music and the call-outs and all that stuff I don't like about the machine.
Okay. What is this? Tell me about this. What is that button?
I think it's the foul shot.
Gotcha.
There's a ball in the back glass.
Oh, cool, like a Circus Voltaire kind of thing?
Yep. When you... get here to Crazy Bob's.
Crazy Bob. Yeah.
Your concessions, the P Pizza Power Shots, I believe it is.
It is Crazy Bob's.
It's got a
just
crazy
like
Bob.
Dialed In. Crazy Bob's is that left shot.
They're Dialed In has Crazy Bob.
Yeah. Oh, it's like
this has Crazy Bob. Junkyard has Crazy Bob.
I forgot who designed this game. Sorry, guys. Who designed this thing?
Gomez.
This is a Gomez game.
George Gomez.
Huh. Very cool.
I think.
Yeah. Coach George Gomez. Very cool. Now, interesting.
Gomez is next side by side.
Yeah, an interesting thing that that you pointed out that I thought I've never heard before. You said the layout on this is very similar, you feel, to what?
To Monster Mash.
So, similar layouts, only about $6,000 difference between the two.
That's right.
Yeah. So what do you like about the Monster Mash? I like the flip. Look at that. Nicely done. I like
it.
Everybody loves this game.
Maybe it was because I liked NBA Fast Break. I don't know.
You heard it here, guys.
Side by side.
He likes Monster Bash because he liked Fast Break.
Play them side by side and see what you
think. Similar feels and stuff, too?
They feel a lot alike.
Okay.
Maybe that's
a Gomez.
Gomez?
Thing,
Gomez.
Yep.
Maybe. But I love them. I love both these machines. This was my favorite machine. These two were my favorites
for a long time. I love me some Bally Williams Gomez.
Yeah.
There's nothing like Bally Williams Gomez. I'll say that. I do like this game. I think the code is...
Yeah,
it's very approachable.
Exactly.
You know what to do.
This machine...
It's hard to master, though. This thing is hard to master.
Both of these machines, they're easy to grasp.
Yeah.
And I think that I got these machines at a time when I started out at Pinball. It made it easier for me to grasp the concept of... I guess I wouldn't call them modes.
Just the different techniques and the different things you're supposed to do in a game.
Yeah. And it's real easy for even a beginner to get.
Very nice. I like it. Let's go look at some more games, guys. What do you guys want to see next? What are we going to look at? All right. We're going to talk about some Revenge from Mars. I like that you put unique things in your lineup. What makes you really like this thing?
This was one that just, it was an opportunity buy.
Okay.
Picked it up. It was at a time, I think I had two pinball machines.
Yeah.
And these two machines came up. These were my number three and number four machine. Bought them together.
Oh, cool. Very nice.
And
you still keep them close together. That's cool.
Yeah, they're still together.
Very nice. So what do you love about that? Because you know what? For me, this machine, a lot of people dog it, but it always kind of draws me in. I think the art is great. It's just intriguing. Now, I'm not going to recommend anybody for their first pin go out and buy a Revenge from Mars by any means. Actually, I would say do not do that. There's a lot of maintenance issues that you have to consider on this. Is that correct?
I haven't had many.
Okay. What scares you about this machine then?
The TV screen scares me.
Scared me too. So you would have
I don't know how it is with this machine, but I know arcade games.
Yeah.
You can retrofit in a
LCD or something.
LCD.
Okay. Very cool. Now, I've got a comment on this. This is a really, really beautiful game, man. Like, was this ever routed?
It was routed.
Oh, wow. It looks take my word for it.
I was proud of this one. I completely stripped this down. You couldn't read any of the inserts.
The routed black sludge was on it?
It was black.
Yeah.
And you couldn't read any
of it. A lot of the old school guys would say that protected it. That sludge protected it.
I've never heard anybody say that, but that makes sense.
A lot of people say that. When you got that big, thick grid, it actually protects from the ball messing up the inserts and stuff over time. Yeah,
I never heard that. But this machine...
So you stripped it down.
I took everything down off of it. I didn't strip the clear coat or anything like that. But
no. But you took everything off of it and...
Polished all the plastic, noticed it, polished the play field.
Wow. So you're pretty proud of this one.
I was pretty proud of this.
You did a hell of a job, man. It's really awesome.
The cabinet's a little rough still, but I don't care about cabinets.
You're not a big...
Cabinets don't mean anything.
You don't play the cabinet, do you?
You don't play the cabinet. I don't even look at the cabinet.
Yeah.
I don't care about...
You shove them in like this, you don't see a damn thing.
I don't care about cabinet artwork. It's kind of, it's a little extra here, but...
Look at that art you got.
That is pretty cool art.
Oh, my gosh.
First time I've ever even looked at the art. Actually.
I always forget about this game. I get it. It has its issues.
Yeah.
But it's stuff like this. Like when I see it in your collection, I freaking want this game.
There's something about pinball, guys. And I'm that way too. When you add video game into pinball, it kind of turns us off.
Yeah, I don't like the video game component to it, but the theme is awesome. The artwork is awesome. The layout is pretty cool. The concept, I think, is pretty good. I kind of like the concept of integrating some video. The problem is, 20 years down the line now, or 17 years down the line, the animations are out of date. You've got a lot of things that just don't feel like 2017.
It's still fun.
That's all that matters. That's all that matters. Speaking of fun, I have a lot of fun when I play this game. And you said,
I don't know what it is.
I would love to have this game long enough to say,
I can't get into it fully.
I still think it's badass that you don't care. You're like, it's not, you know, it doesn't do a lot for me.
I keep trying. I just haven't been able to reach that omega
point. How's that left
point.
Ramp, though? I love that left ramp.
Ramp?
Man, I love that.
It's
so
pretty
smooth.
Cool.
What I like about Papa Dude games is that they have, like, sometimes you don't know, Rick told me in one of the other videos, and he's right, sometimes you don't know where the ball is coming from, because it's got little hide holes and ramps lift up, not necessarily in this game, but for the most part on Papa Duke games, they do that, and it's really nice. This is one of the tops for a reason for me. What do you particularly like about this game? Is there any, you've got, like, the magnet.
That is pretty badass how the magnet
sucks
it down to the playfield.
That is super cool. I just like the layouts. I think this is really...
I stripped this machine down too.
Did you really?
It was fun. I mean, maybe that's why I don't get rid of it.
You don't get rid of any damn thing. And I can respect that. I think it's cool.
I'm going to keep playing this machine.
Sorry.
I'm going to keep playing it until...
You'll never get rid of it.
I've not completed it.
Oh, yeah?
I suck so bad at this machine.
Okay. Man, it's cool. If you guys are like me, I'm like salivating over here. I freaking love this thing.
I don't think I've beat more than three of the tasks.
Yeah? Isn't it weird how... Are you like that too, Tom? Some games, you'll play and everybody digs, but you're like, I'm just not feeling this game. And you come back to it, I'm still not feeling this
game. Let me ask you this. Are you a score guy or are you a task guy?
I'm a mode task guy all the way. That's why I don't really do tournaments or anything. Number one, I'm not good enough. But number two, like, I care about the quest and the journey of something.
Exactly.
I want to get to a wizard mode. I don't care about 20 million or 2 billion.
Yeah, I don't care about the points. The points will come.
Yeah. That's why some of the new Sterns kind of bother me, because Game of Thrones, Ghostbusters not so much, but Game of Thrones is a big multiplier game. Trying to get multipliers the whole time to boost up your score, and it just doesn't feel great to me. I want to get to a mode. I want to start that mode. I want there to be theatrics. I want to complete the mode, get rewarded, and I want to move to the next part of the journey.
And I think that's where The Hobbit and Lord of the Rings comes in.
I think so. Because
they're so, it's
that's a great
pretty
point.
Heavy.
That's a really good point. Yeah, I love the modes. All right, so what we're probably going to do now, dude, you've got so many games here that it's going to be a two-hour video if we go through it. So I tell you what. What we're going to do is we'll scan through, show you guys the other games, and if you're kind enough, maybe when you get Lebowski, we'll
come back,
and we'll look at all the other games,
and who
too.
Who knows what else will be here.
Awesome. All right, guys. Zach from Straight Down the Middle, thanks so much, Tom.
You're welcome.
Awesome. Tom from Indiana, if you guys see him at a show or anything, say hi. Until next week, check us out.
You
later.
You hit it off with a bumper, now you're straight down the middle again. You had a fling with a slingshot, you're rolling out the alley again. I tried to cradle you with my flipper, it was all in vain. It's all in vain. Baby,